Hello, I'm Al Rivera, and this is a Hog 4 PC tutorial for the complete beginner. What in the world is going on, filmmakers? I hope everything is well, that you're safe. And with that said, let's get to this. I do lighting control on a lot of my projects, music videos, movies, and a few persons have asked me to help them out with this program. Notice, program. This is not an app. This is a program. You need a computer or a desktop to run this program. You do not have an app for your tablet or for your phone. This is a real lighting program that's used in many, many theaters, including the Barry Manilow Theater in Las Vegas. A shout out to Rocky, the person who did my movie out there with the Hog 4. Now, with that said, let me run some specs over to you that I got off their website. This is basically what you're going to need for your laptop or computer, mind you. I've put this program on many computers and never really have gone through that whatsoever. Next one. There are a few items here. Actually, there are two. You see four, but there are two. Two are dimmers and two are the controllers. The one that you're going to need is the big one on the bottom that says the Hog DMX. That is a single universe, 512 addresses or channels that gets plugged into your laptop. That you absolutely must have. The dimmer next to it, the big one on the side, holds six channels, and the little one I think is four channels. Those are all DMX. You need those to plug in your light bulbs or your single attribute fixtures. The automated fixtures do not get plugged into these dimmers. The automated fixtures that you're gonna buy do not get plugged in to these dimmers. Got it? The upper right hand corner where you see Hog, that is a four universe of the smaller, of the one in the front. That's a single. The one is a quad. I've never used a quad. I have no need for it. There are two types of cabling in DMX. One is called a 5-pin and one is called a 3-pin. Please get to know, please understand that every manufacturer uses either or either. It is not standard that you must have a 5 or you must have a 3. The higher end fixtures do use 5, that I've noticed, and the lower end has a tendency to use the 3. They are basically two types of lights that you're going to use in this program. One is a single attribute unit. That is a 5K ARRI, a 2K ARRI, and in the middle there's a light bulb. All three are exactly the same thing. You plug them into that dimmer rack, and you can set the intensity from 0 to 100, or in DMX language, from 0 to 256. The other types of units that you're going to use are automated lighting, automated fixtures. There you have a wash, a spot, and a par. These change colors, they zoom in, they zoom out, they wash, they strobe. They are incredible. And that is where the future of lighting is going, DMX controllable units. With that said, this tutorial is hopefully just to get someone who doesn't know anything about DMX or lighting board or programming to watch this and within 20 minutes, 25 minutes, could at least get him or her up and running, practicing at home, and maybe prepare themselves to do lighting for small weddings or churches or things of that nature. So let me go to my desktop and let's get the program up. Go to the internet. Highend.com. You're going to see here that it says etcconnect.com, but they kind of bought out high-end systems. But you want to go to, let me see, where is it? You want to go there. Hey, how, whatever, let me do it this way. Let me see if I can get it. Highend.com. There you go, that's it. It is highend.com, and I notice it converted to ETC. So now that you're here, I'm gonna give you a second to get here. And now I'm gonna take this at a really slow pace. Come on down, stop here. This is the world we want to live in. Hog 4. Hit learn. Hog 4 consoles. These are the big guns. These are the big guns. And very expensive. Notice 16 universes, 12, 8. 6, 64. Now let's go down. This is for us, the little babies. This is a single universe. That's the one I showed you before. Here's the quad. There's 512 channels here. I call them addresses. And they are 512, 512, 512, 512. Let's click here. Because this is what you want. Notice you need to buy this. Without this, all you can do is program. Let's go to software. Let's come right here. Hog 4 PC 3.15. Click it. Download it into your download. I don't. I actually have it here. I keep it in my hog, but you don't have that yet. Put it in your download, and then later on, or with the next upgrade, put it there. Open it, run the program. Once you got the program running, I'll give you a few seconds for that, or pause the video. I'm gonna close this out. We no longer need this. If you paused it and now you're back, you should see this. I hope you restarted your unit. Restart your computer. You should see this. See me here flashing it on and off, 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 on and off. I made a note here. This is what DMX actually stands for, digital multiplex. Okay. And each widget is 512 channels per universe. I call them addresses, because I like to refer to my channels on the dimmers. Let's click this. I get that sound. You're probably not seeing this. I hit yes. Now I'm going to cancel that because I want to go to the startup. This is what you should see, except this is probably blank. You're going to start a new show, put your name in it, on it. Notice new show, launch a show. Once you've done a show or two, they're going to show up here. If you need to see more, you'll find them in browse. This and this, don't worry about it. This and this, don't worry about it here either, because that's inside the program. Help is inside the program, and quit is if you want to quit. Therefore, launch your new show. Once you got it in there, hit it, and your Hog 4 PC is going to come up. So I am going to launch. There we go. Let's grab this. Put it there for now. I usually have two screens, and I put these two windows on the other monitor. And I keep this on monitor one and these on monitor two, the second monitor. First thing is first. Come here, MAP. If you see ABC, go to your keyboard, and hit your pause break. You see, it changed to ABC. Hit it back to map. Map gets your keyboard and your Hog 4 program communicating. That's going to allow you to use it as an input, and you don't have to constantly come here. In the help menu, you'll find a list of shortcuts that you will use on your keyboard to get around all this. Let me put this up. To get all around this. This is about as fast as I'm going to go, because now I'm really going to slow it down. You have one, two screens. These are views. You could customize them. I have. These views you cannot customize. These you could change. These you cannot. What do you have to do now? In order for you to use this program, you have to input into the program the fixtures you are going to use. And as I showed you prior to this, they're basically two types: the light bulb and the automated fixture. Let's start with the light bulb. Come here to setup. Here I am. Setup. Patch. Here I am. Patch. This window's gonna come up. You're not gonna have this, obviously. Come here. Add fixtures. Hog calls a single attribute fixture a desk channel. Generic desk channel. Or if you want to look for something, you can go desk, see, and the desk channel came up. I have 100 desk channels reserved on my system. That leaves 412 addresses open for other lights. Let's put 12, start with 12, you could always change it. Hit apply, hit OK, come out. Come here to where it says patch. So first you did this, now you do patch. Come here, it's gonna automatically patch those 12 single attribute fixtures, 12 desk channels in the first universe, channel 0 through 12. It's gonna go 1 through 12. Press OK, you're in. So you hit setup, you went to patch, you went to fixtures, you put your desk channels, you patch them in. Now come over here to the extreme right, auto palettes, leave it by default, press generate. That's gonna bring up a default setup, which I do not use. Close all. I do not use it, but you're gonna get it, and later on you'll customize it. Now since I did that, I have to go back to setup. You've got setup, we went to patch, we went to add fixtures, we patched them, we created the auto palette, and now we gotta put enter. Auto patch. Hit auto patch, and that's basically like putting enter, and now your program is ready. You have 12 lights. 1 through 12. You see them? At full. They're at 100%. I'm going to open the programmer, which is the most important window you use when you're programming. Now I'm going to show you what happens here. I'm going to resize this. Just using this, watch what happens. Okay? This maximizes it. This moves it to the other side. This brings it back. This copies it. This locks it. Once I lock it, I can't move this around. This closes all the windows. If you had everything open, I'll show you. And you press close all. I have a close all here, and I also programmed one here, just so I didn't have to jump over there. Let's go back to the programmer. There are your lights. I'm going to maximize so you could see it. And this here, up, down, left, right, that's in here. When you have a lot of information here, you can click in here, and then you'll go up, down, left, right, blah, blah, blah. Park is down here. You'll learn that on your own. Output is telling you what is going to the stage. You see, I'm going to move it over. Remember here, I'm going to send it to the other one, and now I'm going to max it out. There you go. Now, while I'm here, before I do anything else, let me show you how to save a view. Come down here to record. Hold down your shift key. Hit record. You notice? Now come here or to any one of these where you would like, but let's do this one right now. Press it, and now you recorded this view, these two. You'll come back down here. Here's my mouse. Come back down here, set, and now you could change the name. Apply, okay, and there it is, change the name. If I close this and I touch this, it comes back. This view is a view directory. It tells you the name of everything you have here. Click it twice, there they are. See, change, or just like Excel, you could grab this, change the name, change the name. And while I'm here, come back down. Here's my mouse, if you see it. Hold your shift, hit delete, come back up to change the name, hit it, okay, it's gone. Now when I press this, there's nothing there. With that all said, let me get the program up. Notice that this is still here. Why? Because even though I've been playing around with the program, I never hit C on my keyboard. Now I did. Now it cleared those fixtures from the programmer. They're gone. If I want them again, I go 1 through 12 at 50, and that's going to put them at 50%. You notice here it says intensity. Notice there are five little bars here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Soft keys, I think they're called. I forgot what they're called. Here are the wheels. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Excuse me, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. This one controls this one. So that's one way to control the intensity. Here is another way to control the intensity. Okay. I have an intensity palette set up right here. So I can go 10, 55, and you see it's changing, but it's only changing because they are dark blue. When they are light blue, I can't control it, and I'm going to show you in a second. Notice I'm going to close again. The moment I open the programmer, those lights are still, those desk channels are still there because I have not cleared them out of the programmer. Remember this? I'm going to move this over. You'll get the hang of this. There we go. Now, notice right here it says select. I'm going to select even. See, it selected 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. I could now, through the intensity or through this spinning wheel, control that intensity. I could select all again. Now they're all selected. I can select the odds. Okay. Oh, there. Did I select even or odds? Let's go. There we go. Let's select them all. And let me see. Odds. Okay, the odds are selected. Here's the dark. And now you could come here. As I said, I have this, and let's put them at 40. There we go. Now that I've done that, let me get this back. I'm going to close everything again for you to see. If I go to the programmer, it's still there. Once again, I did not clear it. Here's the output. I'm going to send the output, move it over there again, and I'm going to max it. I should have just kept that saved here so I could do that automatically. Now I'm going to show you how you're going to save this. This can go on any of these 12 faders, these 10 faders. Press record. Here I only have 10 open. I'm going to click it on 10. And there it goes. It is now saved right here. Now I'm going to press C, and you're going to see that the output clears out because the units are out of the programmer. I'm going to come to number 10, hit play, and there they are. Now they're playing off the cue. And you could save other, I guess, intensities. You could save 3 lights, 4 lights, whatever, and just keep adding cues, and you'll play them, play them, play them, play them, play them. Example, let's go here. I'll do it this way again. Let's say 1 + 3 + 7. Plus 7. Did I do it? There we go. No, I don't want. I have a 77. Let me clear that. Okay. So 1 + 3 + 7. What's wrong with my 7 here? All right. We'll leave it at that. Let's put those at 80. There. I'll record. Put it here. And now I have a second cue there. Watch. Go to cue list. There are the 2 cues that I just recorded. Let me close this. Get the output back up. It's still there. I'm going to click here. Watch it change. There you go. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. That is it. That is the basic core of the programmer. Now, when you put in your automated lights, I'm going to show you that. And we'll just get a close all again. Here, I'm going to get these, and I'm going to put them in. There they go. See them? I'm going to set them at 100. I'm going to close everything here. Then I'm just going to bring up the programmer. I'm going to bring up the output again. You know I'm going to send it over there. I'm going to max it out. I click this. I'm going to max this one out. Watch. Notice here. This has changed now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 is dead. 4, I can give it a strobe effect on this particular unit. This one tilts the unit. This one pans the unit. Here, I can add a color. I added red. I can add a gobo. And I can use a macro. I can now take this, record 10, and I just recorded that as a cue there. While it's still there, I can now come here into effects. Let's say give it a circle effect. That circle effect has now taken place here. You could see it there. I hope I didn't do that too fast. You could have also accessed the effects here. 1, 2, 3, 4. They're still here. Remember, this one's dead. And you could come in here and change every single item individually. Watch. See? I don't want to do that. Just double click it, and you could change each one. Each one you could change. And that's how you go about changing it. Now I can come back here. Here's my mouse again. Record. Put it here. And it's part of that fader. If you come here, I think we saved, what, 4 of them? 1, 2, there we go. We saved 4. That's it. We're ready to go. Let me close everything up. Again, remember, press C to clear your programmer. Check your programmer. Close it up. Now let's get the output up here. And I'm going to come to 10, and I'm going to play it. sorry. There we go. It went to the bottom. So there it is. Okay. And it'll play through here. And you could see here that it's changing. It's 1, it's 2, it's 3, it's 4. That's playing down here. Watch. What number did I use? Did I use 131? I think I used 131, did I? There it is. There you go. Right there. See it? It's playing right here. Because I'm doing this. There's 1, there's 2, that's the third one. And there's the fourth one where I added the effects. That is basically it. Every unit has its own attributes. And you control them in the program specifically through these. Don't forget to record them. Remember, once you save to here, don't forget to clear. Press clear. Now, one last thing. Notice this is running right now. This is on. So just come here and press release. And when you press release, this is gonna, I think, turn purple and it goes away. Release. There you go. Everything here went away because I released that particular fader. You have 10 faders, and then you have pages for faders, you have scenes, you can save scenes. There's kinds, there's commands, there's plots. There's pages. This is unlimited, the knowledge that, no, this is unlimited ability. This has unlimited abilities. It's the only way I could say it. I can't even say it. And those things are so above my pay rate that I can't begin to tell you. You have to watch other tutorials to really get into this. This should get you up and running. Remember, almost every light that you're looking at today claims to have DMX built in. That's the future. That's where we're going. That's where we're headed. And that's what's going to happen. So with that said, I hope you like, review, subscribe, tell people about this one, because once again, this is where we're headed. DMX. And with that, I am out of here.
That's all, folks.